This episode of Underground Reggie is brought to you by the IMN.com. Music, sports, and entertainment news from IMN Media. Follow the IMN on Instagram at IMN.media. Professional wrestling is a form of performance art and entertainment. It combines athletics and theatrical performance. The unique form of sport portrayed is fundamentally based and evolved from classical and catch wrestling. The matches have predetermined outcomes to heighten entertainment value, and all combative maneuvers are executed with the full cooperation of those involved. On today's episode, find out why the sport is experiencing a resurgence. My name is Rico Banks. Today is Monday, October 7, 2019, and this is another episode of Underground Reggie. World Wrestling Entertainment, also known as WWE, is an American integrated media and entertainment company. It's primarily known for professional wrestling. WWE has also branched out into other fields, including movies, football, and various other business ventures. As of 2019, it's the largest wrestling promotion in the world, holding over 500 events a year, with a roster divided up into various globally traveling brands, and is also available to about 36 million viewers in more than 150 countries. As in other professional wrestling promotions, WWE shows are not legitimate contests, but purely entertainment-based, featuring storyline-driven, scripted, and choreographed matches, though matches often include moves that can put performers at risk of injury, even death, if not performed correctly. This was first publicly acknowledged by the WWE's owner, Vince McMahon, in 1989 to avoid taxes from athletic commissions. Since the 80s, WWE publicly has branded their product as sports entertainment, acknowledging the product's root in competitive sport and dramatic theater. The company's majority owner is its chairman and CEO, Vince McMahon. McMahon gained significant traction when he hired AWA talent Hulk Hogan, who had achieved popularity outside of wrestling, notably for his appearance in the film Rocky III. McMahon signed Roddy Piper as Hogan's rival, and then shortly afterward, Jesse Ventura as an announcer. Other wrestlers joined the roster, such as Jimmy Snuka, Don Morocco, The Iron Sheik, Junkyard Dog, Paul Orndorff, Greg Valentine, and Ricky Steamboat. Many of the wrestlers who would later join the WWF at the time were former AWA and NWA talent. The WWF, now WWE, would tour nationally in a venture that would require a huge capital investment, one that placed the WWF on the verge of financial collapse. The future of McMahon's experiment came down to the success or failure of McMahon's groundbreaking concept, WrestleMania. WrestleMania was a major success and it still is marketed as the Super Bowl of professional wrestling. The concept of a wrestling supercard was nothing new in North America. The NWA had been running Starrcade a few years prior. In McMahon's eyes, however, what separated WrestleMania from the other supercards was that it was intended to be accessible to those who did not watch wrestling. He invited celebrities such as Mr. T, Muhammad Ali, and Cyndi Lauper to participate in the event, as well as securing a deal with MTV to provide coverage. The event and hype surrounding it led to the term Rockin' Wrestling Connection, due to the cross-promotion of popular culture and professional wrestling. In May 2018, the WWE signed a massive five-year deal with Fox to air its SmackDown program for an estimated $1 billion. NBC Universal previously had the rights to SmackDown since 2010. The company is reported to have paid about $30 million for the franchise. The show began airing that year on Sci-Fi, with corporate sibling USA heavily promoting it. SmackDown moved full-time to USA in January 2016. It's the cable network home to Mr. Robot, and the center aired all three WWE shows, SmackDown, Raw, and Tough Enough. It marked the first time that the top three shows were broadcast on the same network. SmackDown started airing live in May 2016, increasing the value for advertising during the wrestling show. At the time, USA aired 5 hours of live WWE programming a week, WWE programming currently airs two nights a week on USA. The show recently premiered last Friday on Fox, and its debut drew 3.8 million total viewers, according to Nielsen. As expected, SmackDown fared better in the key demo than it did overall, this making SmackDown another success for the WWE. Coming up next, we'll talk about another company that's helping with the resurgence of professional wrestling. That company's name is AEW.
If you haven't heard about Anchor, it's the easiest way to make a podcast. Let me explain. It's free. There's creation tools that allow you to record and edit your podcast right from your phone or computer. Anchor will distribute your podcast for you, so it can be heard on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and many more. You can make money from your podcast with no listenership. It's everything you need to make a podcast in one place. Download the free Anchor app or go to anchor.fm to get started.
The world of professional wrestling is being disrupted by the first challenger that has WWE legitimately scared for the first time in 20 years. That company is AEW. AEW is funded by Jacksonville Jaguars owner Shahid Khan and co-founded with his son Tony Khan, an established wrestling fan. The Khans represent a $6.4 billion net worth entering the world of wrestling, dwarfing Vince McMahon's $2.9 billion, and coming at a time that McMahon is getting ready to invest significant amounts of money in his new version of the XFL. AEW is doing something very different. They've designed their shows around the fans. They signed the Young Bucks, arguably the best tag team in the world, Hangman Page, and Cody Rhodes, a wrestler who found new life after leaving WWE. The company would later sign Kenny Omega, another one of the biggest wrestlers in the world, and Jon Moxley, one of WWE's biggest stars this decade. Recently, AEW made their television debut. Their Wednesday night series, Dynamite, trumped WWE's Wednesday program, NXT. Dynamite drew 1.4 million viewers to the TNT, while NXT drew 891,000 to USA. Both series air Wednesday nights at 7 p.m. for 2 hours. This has started a new Wednesday night war, and fans are excited by the competition. AEW Dynamite features Cody Rhodes, Brandi Rhodes, brothers Nick and Mac Jackson, the Young Bucks, and Kenny Omega. Other top AEW stars include WWE veteran Chris Jericho, Nyla Rose, and Jon Moxley. NXT is the brainchild of WWE's Paul Triple H Levesque, who developed the brand to serve as a developmental territory for new and up-and-coming talent. Current NXT stars include Adam Cole, Roderick Strong, Shayna Baszler, the tag team of Kyle O'Reilly and Bobby Fish, Matt Riddle, and Keith Lee. This wrestling resurgence is fresh and bringing in viewers. No wonder the money being paid out by networks is huge in 2019. Fans are excited and viewers are growing. I'm sure this isn't the last we will hear about this battle. Thanks for tuning in to today's episode of Underground Rich. I'm your host, Rico Banks. Make sure you follow the IMN on Instagram at IMN.media. We'll be back with another episode soon. Stay tuned.